Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for inviting me here. I'm very happy to be here. And probably my presentation today is different from your perspective from Philippine point of view. But several years I've working for ICON and East Asia countries, so maybe my presentation is not only from Japanese point of view, but also from North African country, Asian country. But during my presentation, if you want to say something or you want to ask me, please raise your hand and I will answer. It's easy. So my presentation today is Museum in Information Society from Collection to Digital Archives. And so my presentation is within 2 hours, but it's too long. So maybe between presentation 1 and 2, we will have some small pause or break, I'm not sure. And 3rd and 4 is more professional. So first I'd like to ask you, in this audience hall, who is the student from the university student? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, and who is a professional who is working in a museum? 2 or 3? 3. And other people from this institute? Okay. So you are not familiar with the museum?
No.
Curator, 3 or 4 curators knows about the museum. But the other person, you are not familiar with museums. Okay. Maybe my term is different from your daily life. And I only know the museums or museum studies. So in my home, I cannot communicate with my wife, with my student, my child, because I'm a specialist and I only watch the museum. Not family, not other countries. But, So I first, first part, I'd like to introduce myself. And first part is basic question, what is a museum? And part 2 is the museum is evolving. So I would like to change your mind from the traditional museum's concept to a new concept. Because every day the world is changing very quickly, and especially the museums in Japan is no more concept of traditional museums. So I'd like to show some pictures and some ideas. And part 3 and part 4 is management issues for museum running. So it's boring for students, but for professional working worker, museum management is very important factor. So I'd like to insist on the management issues. So finally, I'd like to say something about potentialities of agriculture, agri-museums. At first, I'd like to introduce myself. My background is museology. And sometimes English-speaking countries say museum studies, but I am educated in France, so I'd like to use museology. And museology is a museum's logics, or a museum's philosophy, or a museum administration management like this, but museography, on the other hand, we have many technical issues or projects like exhibition or education. So in my presentation, there is a difference between museology and museography. And I have been working for museums over 23 years, but even today I work for museums. And at the university, I teach some kind of information technology in the museums. And to sum up, museology is museum theory, but probably you can ask, what is a museum theory later? And the idea, philosophy, and history, policy, and law, museum administration and management is a field in museology. But museography is more technical, planning, conservation, restoration, and museum documentation. And museum documentation at the university I teach for the museum digital archivings. So if you want to know more about museology, museology is the study of organization and management of museums, and sometimes we include museum collections or collection theory and theory of museums. So museum consists of three parts. One is space, of course, physical space, but today virtual space is our target for study. And collection, without collection, we cannot say museums. But in some country, it depends on the definition. Let's think about a science center or science, a children's museum. British speaking country or Swiss or Belgium or Spain, France, they cannot accept a museum like a children's museum, science center. But American Association of Museums accept science center is one of the important museums, because children's museum or science center is the most important educational institution. So they accept the children's science center is a museum. But it depends on the country. And Japan accept the children's museum or science center or garden, botanical garden, zoo, and planetarium without a collection, just the image of the show. But we accept a museum. And the center, the museum, is a visitor. But today's situation is completely different. Physical visitor, not only physical visitor, but also virtual visitor is our important target. So physical space, physical visitor, but we also in the virtual space, in virtual visitor. And my research in material culture, but how do I say, I am, last year I am 60 years old. And 60 years old, Chinese culture, Japanese culture, Korean, 60 years old is a turning point of the life, you know. So I begin to change my spirit also, and I study material culture, but today I'm very much interested in the spiritual culture, because museum should be a spiritual culture center, because we are interested in the material objects, historical artifacts and so on, but using this object, we can develop ourselves in our life. So spiritual culture is more important. This is my impression during after 30 years experiences. But mainly museum deal with movable and immovable, like a heritage site or architecture or archaeological sites. So immovable is more important. And from small object to a big object, museum material or museum objects, but there are so many objects physical objects, but considering the agri museums, we need to think about not only object but also the information. Information about digitalized data. So written or unwritten material, and living and motionless still life is our target for study. That means everything is our study's target. And my field of research is mainly European countries, North Africa. So I will show you later, Libya. I have been working for Algeria, Morocco, Tunisia, but mainly Libya, and Turkey, Romania, France. I will show you just a quick. Hagia Sophia Museum, I have been working since 2005, and I made some making a risk management manual, because the dome here will be falling down within 100, 200 years later. So my professor, my teacher, examine every year. So each year, 0.7 millimeter is widening and spread. So I'm not sure, 100 to 200 years later, the dome will fall down. Actually, three times the dome, a small dome, was falling down. So in case of falling down, how the visitor escape to the exit? So I made research during 5 years, and I presented to the government, Turkish government, and finally I made a manual of the escape. And conservation environment, I measure this part because this part is deteriorated because of the temperature. So left on the left, there is a big window, and every winter and every summer, the temperature is different. So the tessera will fall down. So how can we protect these mosaic paintings, which was constructed 12th century and 13th century? So this is another project, is a Sabrata archaeological site, and to make a new open-air museums. How can we use this space? And another archaeological site, Leptis Magna, this is one of the World Heritage Sites, and we measure how the visitor walk and how many hours. So this is my research, and at the university, I practice and field work using the museum material and historical building. I teach to weave this collection of this data. That is my experience at the university. So first question, first part. What is museum? I'd like to ask you the basic question. So you know, the most beautiful lady in the world, Mona Lisa. Do you know, can you imagine visitors watch carefully this Mona Lisa? No, I mean, how long? How minutes? Every year, 7 million visitors. And first time I studied in France, I measure the Japanese visitor, 1987 to 1988. And the Japanese visitor came here, and within 1 hour. But here, around here, 20 minutes Japanese is stay, not only this, but also the museum, and 40 minutes for souvenir shop. And my mother, I invite, when I stay in Paris, I invite my mother, and I suggest to my mother, and you can visit, and she visited with my elder brother. And after that, I ask a question. Did you watch carefully Mona Lisa? And my mother said, oh, just quick look. Oh, 10 seconds or something. Second. And then she bought many souvenirs. This is the reality. But did you visit here? Did you meet? According to the research, most of the people watch carefully Mona Lisa within the 30 seconds.
Yes.
Over 1 minute, there's nobody. Look here. With the most beautiful lady, and they watch. This is the reality. So the planner or director or curator wants to show something from the museum's point of view as a curator, as a professional, but actually this is picture with Mona Lisa. So we have to think about the operator of the museum and the visitor. There is a big difference. And I showed you before this. 2 years, during 2 years I studied here. And how long do they watch? The result is the same as Mona Lisa. Just 30 seconds, within a 30 second. Nobody, just I observed, and one Japanese visited mosaic paintings, and he said like this, over 5 minutes. 5 minutes, it's incredible. And behind, I do watch carefully, and then I asked the Japanese, who are you? I'm an architect. Oh, it's a professional. So this is rare case, but most people, is just like this Mona Lisa. You know, what is the museum? Museum is a symbol of the nation. Louvre Museum, or British Museum, or big name, Hermitage, and Japan, National Museum, Tokyo National Museum. But the idea of the symbol of the nation, it's finished. We say forum type museums. It's more familiar with the citizens. But before the symbol of the nation, Japanese government used these buildings as a symbol, but also stock room, stockyard. But nowadays, completely changed in Japan, I'm not sure in Philippines. But tool for education, it's a learning center. So we do not use the name of museum, learning center or community center or I don't know how to say, familial center or something like that in Japanese. So another basic question is, how many museums in the world? Is there anyone who can answer this question? Even icon, they don't know. But generally, American Association Museums count over 18,000. In Japan, as of 2011, 5,747. But maybe next year, one museum will close or not. I don't know exactly. France, 2005, and the UK, 1,800, and Korea, 1,200. China is very interesting. Several years ago, 2000, but now 3,500, and then within a few years, 5,000 or 6,000. Taiwan is growing, 800. And I don't know, Philippines, how many?
You should know.
20?
20.
Talking,
don't know it. And the face of media, just 12. And among 12 museums, 4 museums is closed.
4
closed. So just 8 in a big country, but 8. So as a consultant, I propose to the archaeological department, it is easy to organize to be more specialized museums in Libya, because just 8 museums. So one is for natural history, one is desert, and one is rock painting, and so on. But Philippine, I don't know, I should work next time. So this is a diagram. Japan is growing like this, and Korea like this, Korea like this, and China. And this car will work, maybe within 2 years or 3 years later. So we have to think about the environment of the museums. I pointed out 4 major factors. One is policy, and one is economy, and one is society, and last one is technology. Because the more technology advanced, the more the concept has changed. And I say PEST, so another PEST, management. PEST means, in a biology, another meaning. But I choose a PEST, global change, as I said here. But the museum environment towards professionalism, performance is more needed, because Japanese government or local authorities always pushes to Japanese museum curator, museum director. Performance is important for the taxpayer. Okay, and accountability or transparency. But the museum's performance is needed. And ethics, code of ethics, or behavior, or professionalism is important, and standards, the way of thinking is different. And we need to do practice for professionalization, and ethics education is also important, and skill up, and the training. So PEST is one of just an idea for you to control or to manage for museum running. And another issue in Japan is that museum law and code of ethics for museum professional. We don't have code of ethics, but since 2010, we studied, and the Japanese Association of Museums and Icon of Japan created the code of ethics, the basic 10 principles. And the training course at the university area and the professional course and development evaluation system. This is another issue for evaluation, because generally speaking, the numbers of visitors are evaluated as a performance indicator. And another one is risk management. We have many natural disasters. Maybe here in Philippines, you have many typhoon and strong rain. So museum professionals should think about to protect the collection from the natural disaster. But unfortunately, we don't have the risk management manual. But 10 years ago, before the big earthquake in Japan, 2008-9-10, Japanese Ministry of Education set up the Risk Management Committee, and I was the chair. And I organized the policemen, firemen, and the school, teacher school, and museum curator, and so on. And during 3 years, we published the risk management manual, and it is open on the website. And using this three manual, nobody understand the importance of this manual. And then 2011, the big earthquake hit upon a good hit upon Japan. And after big earthquake, National Committee on Cultural Heritage and Ministry of Education made a symposium, and I was coordinator, and I apologized in front of the museum professional. I published three manuals for risk management, and the Japanese Association of Museums distributed 4,000 copies to the museum. But in a museum director's office, they keep just a manual. They don't read. So during 3 years, the efforts of the 3 years, nobody knows. So I apologize, and in order to level up of the risk management spirit, we should educate even the professional. Anyway, revision of museum's law, it was 2008. So towards 2008, we made a big research. But after 2008, we don't study anymore. But again, we have to revise the museum's law, because the museum's law is the basic consensus. And desirable image of the museum, this is the first political report of the museums in Japan. In order to publish this political report, we invite 300 museums director to the Museum Association of Museum in Japan, and we discuss long discussion in order to survive the museums in Japan. So of course collection is important, but traditional curator, museum director think about only collection. They don't mind about the museum management or communication. Some people, some curator or some educator speak about the importance of communication, but generally speaking, the collection is the first priority. But in order to survive the museums, we need a management. So JMMA, Japan Museum Management Academy, was established 20 years ago in order to expand the idea of the management issues. So what is the museum function and its role? Museum has many functions, of course collection, and conservation, and exhibition, and education, and research. And in your case, what is the most priority agriculture, agri-museums? Education. So, education for professional, or education for students, education for... Who is the target? We have to think about our main target. But fiscal target, beyond fiscal target, you have many virtual target, or virtual visitor, virtual scout, virtual curator, or virtual visitor. So the idea should be expanded. It depends on the priority, because Libyan case I studied here, and this is the backyard of the museum. But they are so valuable objects. So in this case, the collection here is most important. They don't mind about educational activities because it depends on the situations in Libya, because there was a revolution several years ago, 2011, and there are so many stolen objects, and they was sold. So if we can compare with other countries, this is Japan and this is China. So the what type of institution do you think a museum is? Japan think about this 77% and 84.5%. B is an educational institution. So Japan's museum's priority is education, and E, an institution that promotes knowledge and culture. But A, social service institution, we don't think about this. But China's case, A, a social service institution, the average is higher than Japan. And here, number C, a recreation and leisure institution. The Chinese, they don't think so, 24%. So like this, and this is a report of ICOM ASPAC, Asia Pacific, and this is one of the research survey. And I cannot find a Philippines case, so maybe you can do. And around here, there is a data from Malaysia, so I can compare with the Malaysia. So the big difference is the an educational institution. This is Japan. Japan thinks the more importance in the field of education as an institution, educational institution. But Malaysia, they don't think educational institution. So D is a little bit the same. So I don't know the Philippines concept or policy, but before conceptualization of the new museum, you have to know the needs and you have to think the seas. Okay? And the classification of the museums, this is a big topic since 1946. Because 1946, ICOM has established under the umbrella of UNESCO. And at that time, this is some idea of the classification of the museums. So this says founder depends on the founder, national museum, local authority, prefecture museum, city museum, or today in Japan, university has a university museum. But in Korea, Korean university has to have the library and museum, both. But in Japan, we don't have the university museum. University has library. So my university has 5 libraries. Main central library, which has 4 million books and so on. But my department has also a small library on information science, and medical science and so on. But unfortunately, we don't have the museum. We have only a gallery of memorial gallery for Nobel Prize. 3 physicians has Nobel Prize. So we have only gallery. And I insisted on the importance of museum, but headquarters didn't they do not accept. But within 7 years or 6 years, we have a 150 years anniversary of the university. So for that goal, I have already presented our university's museums, but they say they will create archives. So in the archives, we will insert some objects. So anyway, the classification of the museum, we think about general museums, but at the same time, we have to think about a specialized museum. And today, virtual museum or digital museum is more important. So specialized museums, we can count several museums: archaeology, history, art, sculpture, mosaic museum, painting museums, natural history or nature museum, science and technology or science center, folklore or ethnology or ethnography, and agriculture museum. In Japan, we have an agriculture related museum. It is, which is established by corporate company in the field of industry, agriculture, forestry, fishery. We have agriculture museum and a forestry museum and oils museum, milk museum, three or four milk museum, and the salt museum, and the mushroom museum. And the mushroom museum in my prefecture, Ibaraki prefecture, there are two mushroom museums. And the kelp, seaweeds, and soy sauce museum, kikkoma, you know. Kikkoma. And the potato museum, and nowadays, tomato museum. Tomato. And soybeans paste museum, and imagine, and pear, and orange museum, and pineapple museum, and professional women's diver museum is the woman who dive into the sea and who to take the oyster. So, and Korea, they have the same museums in Jeju Island, and we have several museums in Japan. So like this, this is a kind of specialized museum. So this museum should be keep the collection or history of the company, but for the visitor, it's very funny, amusing. But nowadays, the number, not only number, but also the contents of the exhibition, it varies and expanding. For example, do you know ramen? Noodle? Japanese noodle or Chinese noodle? Ramen museum we have. And it is an entertainment, it's like a Disneyland, expanded, expanded. And we have many kind of ramen, noodle, from Hokkaido to South Kyushu. So each tenant in a, I say a restaurant, ramen restaurant, in an amusement park, there are 50 or 60 ramen restaurants. It's a competitive. But several times I visit there to eat. But it is not a collection type museum, it's just a restaurant. But considering architecture related, we can expand our idea or our concept like an open air museum, because agriculture is also the space for open air. And eco museum, this is a French invented concept. Eco museum is, I think, a good idea for agri museums, and sometimes we say site museums. So, in case of agriculture, what would be the collection object or plant itself or botanical garden here in this campus. For me, for Tokyo metropolitan servant, this is a botanical garden everywhere. Very beautiful. But living animals, do you think about domestic animals in this museum or like zoo or gene bank or seed collections? And British in London, there is a science museum and they expand gene bank and they have restoration or gene experimental laboratory, and they open to the public. And any other collection. We have to think about educational information. So information itself, or digital data itself, is one of the important collections. So if you think about the site museum, I think this is the site museum already, but field or garden should be more attractive for a tourist. So I'll give you an example of Tokyo Nogyo Daigaku, the Tokyo University of Agriculture. They have a museum. And they have a permanent exhibition, but also temporary exhibition. They change every 2 months or 3 months, and they distribute it. They organize a traveling exhibitions. So traditionally, we museum people think the visitor come to the museum. But today, in Japan, the museum go outside. We call it outreach program. But because the number of visitors is limited. But using internet or temporary exhibition or traveling exhibition to go around Japan, everywhere we can go. So packaging is one of our target or our strategy. So they changed a little bit strategy. Tokyo Nodai Agriculture Museum, they have many special collection. Instruments for agriculture planting, but this is not so important for exhibition because this is static, it's not dynamic. So they, someone criticized this museum is attractive for senior high school students because in order to get client for the university. So the target, main target is senior high school students. That means the content is not so specialized at a high level for the general public or family to understand the importance of agriculture. Because you know, Japan is more information society. They don't insist on the importance of agriculture, so the client, students cannot, the university cannot come to the university, so the strategy for attracting clients for the university, so they open, they change, renovate the museum. Now they have another greenhouse. They say a bioreum, so several bioreum they have. Another example is at Tsukuba, my town, agriculture research hall. They don't say the museum, research hall. So hands-on type exhibition, and they organize an educational program for students, for family. This is a national agency, national organization. National Agriculture Research Organization. So you can visit the website. So the last basic question, what is the museums? definition of museum by ICOM, International Cultural Museums, adopted by General Assembly Australia, 2007. And there are several definitions from 1981 to 2007. Definition itself evolved. And museum is a non-profit, a permanent institution in the service of society, and we Japanese don't think service of society institution. Chinese insist on the service of society. But its development open to the public, which acquires, conserves, researches, communicates, and exhibits tangible and intangible heritage. Until 2004, in the definition of museums, intangible heritage is not included. But after 2004, the definition of museum includes intangible heritage. So the definition itself evolved, and the purpose of education and study and enjoyment. One of Japanese most important collection of Mitsui family, Mitsui Foundation, they have a very special collection, but they don't open to the public. They keep, but some request to visit, and we should be registered. What's your purpose, and what are you doing? So once the visitor register, and then Mitsui Museum open to the visitor, like this. So why do we have a museum? One is collection, or in this case, specimen, or how do we study or care for the collection, and conservation for the future generation, or open to the public, local development. This means a tourist to show our rich culture, or research, scientific research, or history, and archaeological exhibition. But I want to say something about an exhibition, because exhibition is always connected strongly with education for showing the local culture, because younger generation don't understand who I am, who I come from. So we are living in our rich culture, our local culture, but at the same time, this exhibition contributes to establish national identity. So if I don't know Filipino, what is your main identity? Is it agriculture or fisher or 7,000 island? I don't know. What is your identity? And there is a big discussion, because when we are asked what is your identity for Japanese people, and Japanese people answer, our identity is like a Kyoto or Nara. It's not a Hokkaido, it's not a Tokyo. Because the origin of the Japanese nationality or identity comes from Kyoto, old capital. So school education, we do not educate about our identity, but the only one place who can educate is a museum. So the beginning of my presentation, I say the spiritual culture is important. So I think museum education can be connected with national identity or spiritual behavior or something like that. Okay, next slide shows you some difference between Louvre Museum and Cyrene, Libya. This is my picture. I took my picture, so don't worry about the copyright. And this is, you know, the famous sculpture. But the same epoch, the North African country, they have the same sculpture like this. Of course, this part is a restoration, reproduction, but the size is almost the same. And there is no wing. Wing, but here in Louvre Museum, many tourists have many ideas because 7 million visitors each year, and here just 60 Japanese here, scientists, including me. Mm-hmm. So the big difference between the two. But in order to keep the cultural property, cultural heritage, we need an environment to protect. So we need some special architecture, because every time wind, sand, and my colleague who examined the deterioration of the surface of this sculpture, and small sand, how do I say, touch, destroyed, how do I say, hit. So small, if in this stone, there is a small hole, small sand enter into this hole, and the wind, and they took drill, and then dip into the stone, and then crush. So this should be considered for creating a museum. I move to the second part. Is it okay?
Yes.
Are you tired?
No.
I'm tired. Sorry. And I'd like to talk about evolving from collection to information. Do you want to say something?
No.
And information value and the relation between society and museums. This is a French Museum of Natural History. I don't know, 2 million specimens here, gallery, from small to big one. And I studied here in 1987. And this is an institution, not only museum, but also the institution who can provide PhD degree. Museum can provide PhD. And this model case we want to do in Japan, National Science Museum want to be a more higher education institution. And from the National Science Museum can provide PhD degree, but the Ministry of Education cannot accept because we have no staff, for no professor, no 60 over 60 researcher, but there's no professor. So to be a professor, we are examining our curriculum vitae and the academic payments also. In the National Science Museum, we don't have a professor. It's very difficult. But of course, the idea is always evolving and expanded. So I'd like to show the Japanese case. The concept of the museum collection is now expanding. Historical building is a museum object. I cannot imagine 30 years ago when I begin to study, I begin to work in a museum. Historical building is another world. And today, cultural scenery, landscape is a museum object. The idea is different. Last year, there was a ICON General Conference in Milano, Italy, and the main theme was landscape. And landscape is of course cultural heritage according to the Japanese Cultural Heritage Law Act, but as a museum people, landscape is not an object, But today, the concept of museum includes the landscape and intangible heritage is also a museum object to deal with the idea of heritage and the craftsman technique. Can you imagine a craftsman technique? We have a carpenter, special carpenter who can create shrine or temple. That is a national heritage. And several years ago, the craftsman who can create a ship, boat, that is a national intangible heritage accepted. And today, digital data, no physical collection. So 2008, the museum's law has revised. Museums should collect the digital data. Can you imagine? Without operating system, OS, a floppy disk, museum as a museum object, floppy disk or MO or USB, we can collect, but how can we watch or observe the data itself? But National Film Archive Center collect many collection film data, USB, and even today, NHK broadcasting, NHK has established NHK archives, several stories, big stock room, and they collect many few data in order to provide the data as an information. So museum deal with intangible, tangible, removable, but we have to think about the digital data for future generation from now. And the concept of cultural heritage itself is extended. As a professor of Tsukuba University, we have to establish a new discipline to attract the students as possible as we can. And record heritage is a kind of archival science. So record heritage, we have this discipline already. Here you can see the cold open, which is a historical and a national, special national monument. Since 2003, I worked for this monument, and here, my university motto, Nagasaki, is here. From here to Nagasaki, it's about 1,200 kilometers. And Nagasaki, this is a restoration, replica, real size, but this, can you see the difference, the color? This is a reproduction, and this is original size. So using this part, this is a new building. And this part is a museum. And this is a, this is a local government of a Tokugawa period. And this is a tax office and a court, And this is a restoration main gate using the original map. And there are several collections. And the real size, not real size, for exhibitions, layout, study. And using this map, we can use the audiovisual system. And from past to present, the evolution of the city. So we can control by computer, of course. And some students, or some visitors, use the iPad or something like that, immovable information devices. So it's a very good occasion to think about a new target, new information, new strategy, or new space. If we can think about a specific term, like object and collection, or property or heritage, or digital heritage or digital archives, we general people cannot understand the difference between specific term. But object, according to Martin Scherer, who is a museologist in Switzerland, we are surrounded by things in our daily life. They have a utility function. This is the first meaning, first reality. And second reality is a special non-thing relationship. So in considering the agriculture, there are so many instruments for planting or agriculture, but there are several stories between man and thing or instrument. So things are decontextualized from the first reality. So if the object into the museum, the object itself will be recontextualized. So someone or a curator or some scenario writer can describe the scenario or making an exhibition story. So new imaginary context will be happening. And third reality is a personal. Man creates objects by having a personal dialogue. So there are so many possibilities to use the object. And property, do you say in Philippine object and property? Do you distinguish between the two?
Big difference.
Later, let me know. I will be your student. And the property means a movable object. Am I right? No? According to the Japanese cultural properties law, cultural property is movable. And very rare case, human national treasure, human craftsmanship. But that is a rare case. But heritage, not only movable, but also archaeological site or environment, archaeological site and so on. So between the two, big difference. But happily or unhappily, there is a trend in usage of a term. It's a kind of fashion. In Japan, we do not use digital property, but we use digital heritage and digital archive. But internationally, or international standard organization, they use a digital collection. We may misunderstand the original meaning, and we live in a world of ambiguity. But this is not a university course, so just an example. In Japan, before 1972, the word, or the term, heritage, is a very special meaning. And in front of the public, or in front of parents, or grandmother or grandparents, we cannot open our mouths to say heritage. Because this heritage word means, includes negative meaning, very negative, from as a succession, from parents to child. Papa or mama, how much money do you have? If you passed away, please give me your money, like this. So it's as a confusion, Chinese culture or Korean culture, Japanese culture, we cannot say about the money, about the heritage, about our property. So it's prohibited to speak in front of parents. But since 1972, I'm sure, UNESCO World Heritage Convention has accepted. So today, thanks to the books on World Heritage, or a DVD, or NHK television program, or TBS, television broadcasting system in Japan, thanks to the media, we lost our negative meanings. Heritage has changed to a positive meaning. So it's easy to say heritage. So big difference from 1972. So like this, when new concept has arisen, for example, concept A or concept B, merged or meet, happen or unified, new concept will happen. So museum, traditional meaning, museum, but today, digital museum. So I ask to my students, what is the difference between digital museum, digital library, digital archive? Nobody can answer, and me too, I cannot answer. But a museum, traditional museum or digital new museum is a concept A. An archive or digital archive as a concept B. And a concept X, unknown, probably museum archive or digital something, digital organization, so memorial, I don't know exactly. But new museum archive or new concept will be happening. Like this, a cultural heritage online, which is organized by National Agency for Culture, Munkaisan Online, we classify the epoch, the research area or region area. So we classify the architectural heritage or traditional building, painting, woodblock and painting and so on. And epoch, Edo period, Kamakura, Taisho, Meiji, and so on. So Japan is moving towards digital collection. We are enforced, or Japanese government provoked to digitalization. So each year, national museum, for example, Tokyo National Museum, Kyoto National Museum, or Nara Museum, National Museum, Kyushu National Museum, four national museum is, should be 10,000 museum collection should be digitalized, 10,000 each year. But behind the schedule, for example, 8,000, Japanese government push for digitalization. And another example is a virtual collection of masterpieces, ASEMUS, Asia European Association, and they opened the website, this virtual collection. So I took part in this conference in 2008, so first visit to Philippines, I came here. And Japanese government, it's an international trend, digitization. But before digitization, as a museum profession, I'd like to insist on the importance of informatization or information to text. Because without text, we cannot understand the value of the object, value of the information. So we learn from the text. So not only digitalization, but also informatization. But before, we need recording or documentation for inventory or cataloging. Maybe you cannot imagine Japanese library, 99.9% library, OPAC, you know, online public access catalog. Library, information, all books are digitalized. Even today, the university library, since 1990s, the end of 1990s, they digitalized the paper. For example, my paper should be contributed to the library, digital library of the university. So every information in library are collected by digitalization, but in museum, even on a paper catalog, analog, in Japan, 20% of the museum has catalog. We cannot understand these percentages. The rest of the museum, 80%, has no catalog, no inventory. Especially folklore museum has no catalog. History museum, they have no catalog. Archaeology museum have no catalog. Only art museum have catalog over 80%. So when we discuss about digitalization or website creation, but before we have many things to do, recording or making catalog or inventory. This is the reality in Japan. Another example is, in your case, AgriMuseum. This idea comes from agriculture, but this comes from museum. But considering the educational activities, or digital collection or museum, in the center has concept CX. What is the name? What is your name? Learning center. Or so museum, general people likes the name of museum because it has already known the museum. But the new name is very difficult to understand. For example, I work in a French biggest science center, La Cité des Sciences et de l'Industrie, Science and Industry City. But the idea of the city is not a museum. The biggest science center in Europe, in the world, but nobody understands the city is a museum. So new concept is very different from citizens. Now I'll show you a little bit quickly. This is the place where I work. 2011, big earthquake hit Mito City, of course. And this is the damage, completely destroyed. But thanks to my students and me, I took a picture everywhere, every season, each small part, and over 80,000 pictures. 80,000 pictures over 10 years, I think. And the restoration construction company used my picture, and they restore completely. The office of this site asked me, "Why, Professor Mizushima, you come here every time? You take a picture everywhere. Why? The same place. One picture is enough." But I bring my students to the site and take a picture every time, everywhere. So like this. This is a monument, stone monument, which was created by the founder of this school. This is the first school in Japan, in Edo period. The description is the philosophy of the founder Tokugawa Nariaki. And why I established this school? Because the modernization of Japan should be more important and so on. And thanks to the Confucius, we should do something like this. This line is damaged by World War II. But at the same time, this is damaged by 2011 because of the earthquake. Many small pieces of stone, marble stone. And here, the description was destroyed. We cannot distinguish, we cannot read anymore. But 1 year, the professional restored. And after 1 year, the government asked to the office of the site, please check the quality of restoration. Can you imagine the quality of restoration? Who can judge? Nobody. But the office secretary asked me, oh, Professor Mizushima, you are professional. So can you evaluate the quality of the stone monument restoration? And I think, how can I recognize the quality or restoration technique and so on? So using the original wood block print, this is a popular museum. And we took a picture, many pictures we have. And the first restoration after World War II, I collected many pictures and using computer software, Photoshop and so on. And my student analyzed. So red part here is the second damage. So first, of course, I want to show you the first restoration quality, second time and so on. But this is the result of the red part. So using digital technique, we can compare the quality of the restoration. Another project is digital art. Someone criticized using the digital art because normally Japanese wood print is like this, white and black. But my students organized some rainbow color, and people cannot understand this color. But I made a research with my students in summertime. We organized a temporary exhibition, digital art collection. And we exhibited 20 art like this, artworks, this way, color print, and that way. So very long corridor, the visitor watch the color print, and then the visitor return like this, and white and black. So they can watch two color and black and white. And I made a questionnaire, anket, and 200 visitors say yes or no about color print paintings. And can you imagine, is it acceptable or not? Oh, I must ask you. Can you accept this modification from historical value? This is original. This is black and white. So as a museum people, I like this. Filipino. Do you accept this? Please raise your hand. Who can accept these artworks? Nobody! Nobody! Wow! It's surprising. And who accepts this?
She's a Sorry?
It's easy to read in black and white, but that one, the background.
Oh, good question. But my students,
difficult to read.
Each character by character, and the student presented each meanings by PowerPoint presentation, origins, and modern Japanese. So it's easy to understand from this. I understand Filipino is more traditional. Anyway, Japanese visitor, 50% it is acceptable, and 50% this is not acceptable. Yes. So in my classroom, I use this slide, and I ask, and the computer science students, they accept this. But a curator who wants to work really in a museum, they do not accept only this. So the idea or concept. Oh, do you want to ask me a question?
With your 200 sample, that you had 50-50, did you have a segregation of age? Like, were
there young people
who liked it more?
Yes. generally, adults, not the students. So all people, the old age person cannot accept this. But ladies, Japanese lady accept this. Because I think Japanese lady has enough time. Japanese lady have money. Rich women visit art museum. But according to the questionnaire, social education enquete survey, fishery people and agriculture people do not go to the museum. And the older generation is only by women, rich women, rich family, who have enough time. So maybe the women who accept this is very influenced by art, modern art works and so on. Next time, check. So using the original, not original, old picture, but when I go to the site with my students, can you see the difference between the two? This is a step, this is a slope, 100 years ago, but today, this is a step. There is a small gate, but this is not. So this is a postcard. Mito City Museum has many collections, so small postcard was digitalized. And today, we don't have a castle, but because this was destroyed by the World War II. And this is a plan of the restoration. So we take a picture, we overlap, and then this is a wood block print. Can you see the house? Lake. And here, Rita, my student, take a picture. And this is a sketch by the university students, Tokyo National University of the Arts. And thanks to this sketch, the original building house was destroyed by the World War II. But thanks to this sketch, the new production restoration has happened. So from this house, the king or emperor or Tokugawa family can see this lake. Tsukuba is like this. So from now on, part three. Are you tired? I'm tired.
I have a question.
Yes.
One of the restorations you showed, the one with the steps versus the one with the ramp. Mm-hmm. If there was a restoration, why did you not have a ramp instead of steps?
Sorry, I don't understand.
The present is steps, yes. Stairs, but the original is ramp,
yes.
Slope. So restoration does not necessarily adhere to what is original?
Ah, I see. This part was destroyed by World War II. So, I think when this monument, this site was recognized as a special national heritage, they have a big discussions, but this is not for the scenery, and they created, at first they created a parking here.
Parking
lot. Well, but today this is no more, but the beginning of modernization, there is a parking. So they do not understand from the original to the to the present situations. I'm not sure. Is it okay?
Thank you.
So from now, I will speak about management issues for museum running, museum operation. So I'd like to show just one example of Japanese National Council of Education, because AgriMuseum is strongly connected with educational activities, I think, and management factors. 2007, Japanese National Council of Education, it's outside of the Ministry of Education, but very influenced committee, council, and 21st century is knowledge-based society. So museum and library archives work together. Because museum people consider only museum. Librarian consider only for library. Archivist only for archives. But the culture or information resources towards knowledge-based society, we cannot distinguish museum, this is museum, this is library, this comes from archives. So the knowledge or information resources, museum work together with library or archives. So the collaboration is very important. Japanese National Council of Education declares the importance of collaboration. But unfortunately or happily, I don't know, a museum curator, even today, curator thinks my own territory. But can you distinguish between digital museum, digital library, digital archives? I cannot answer the difference or definition. So in order to move from now to a 21st century's knowledge-based society, of course we need an intellectual property right to be kept, but we work together. And building sustainability society, education for sustainable development is necessary, of course, and society of knowledge cycle. Knowledge cycle means from old generation to younger generation, from grandmother to mother to daughter, like this. Unfortunately, when we resign the museum professional, there is no know-how transfer, but technical knowledge do not transfer to younger generation. That is a big problem. So for next generations, today's museum is different from old ones, and the concept of museums and related terms are always evolving. I showed the property, heritage, and so on. Digital museum is popular now in Japan, a virtual museum. And our mind is changing because of the development of technology. 5 years ago, do you use iPad? No. Just 4 years, 3 years, I think. So thanks to the iPad, we can communicate everywhere. Wi-Fi. Can you imagine Wi-Fi? 10 years ago? No. Without Wi-Fi, how can survive? I cannot read Wi-Fi because I was educated in France. So I said when I first see the term, Wi-Fi. And another example is Nike. N-I-K-E. Nike. Do you say Nike? And I pronounce Nike. French pronunciation. It's like this. Anyway, Wi-Fi or iPad changes our mind, our behavior. Our society demands different ways accordingly what we need. And virtual visitor requests more and more detailed information. We cannot get an information, oh, this site is from museum, this is from library. We don't mind. Google. Do you use Google? So Googleization is a globalization. Because museum, library, archive have rich information resources. Why can we distinguish this is museum territory, this is library territory, this is archive territory? We do not need to distinguish between the two or three. We can distinguish because of our own survival, our territory. Administratively, we need our territory. But for younger generation or future generation, we cannot say, oh, this is my own territory. We change our mind. We need a change, our policy. 5 management factors. One is human resources, and another one is object, and another one is budget, money, and time, and information. These 5 management factors is very important to consider the new museums. For example, I teach to my students collection management, physically, the object used to museums and documentation. For example, cataloging or documentation, you use a PC and the research and open to the public. But at the same time, nowadays, not physical movement, but also information move to another institution, another museum, another people on the website. Another one is a human management factor, human resources. We have, in Japan, we have 280 universities who provide curators program for new curator, 280. Before, 300 universities had a program for a curator, but today a little bit slowed down. But they lecture only on the desk and reading the book. But my lecture, my training course is always like this. you can read a textbook in your home, but university with many instruments, they can try and error, and this making a picture, this camera and so on, lighting technique and so on. The importance of professional education in my university, at least as far as I know, only my university can provide like this, because it costs much money. 20 digital camera, 20 sets for students' use, and designing for training course and museum design research. So I created a large aspect of my research institute in order to be more flexible. There are many demand from China, from Korea, from Taiwan, but the university cannot accept for training. But private, as a private company or private institution, it is easy. If I accept, it's okay, you can do, you can try. So in order to exchange more flexibility, work aspect, and of course some kind of demand to cooperate with other institutions, this organization can do. And I collect, I invite many professionals to organize, to consultancy this kind of project. This is one of the pictures. They can try to take a picture using lighting and so on. But to run the museum, we need three factors, as I said before. Museum management and collection. Utility, the collection, and museum communication, exhibition, education, and so on. For professional risk management, as I said before, risk management. If natural disaster happens, at the moment we need some blah 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 blah. And before, we have to prepare against natural disaster. And after, how can we do? How can we survive like this? So this kind of knowledge we explain, but in a university or a special course which is organized just 90 minutes or 2 hours, it is impossible. So Madagascar can organize this kind of special seminar. If you have 1 week, we can try to do 1 week. If you want to stay 1 month, we can do. So this is our merit of the Madagascar. Are you tired? It's okay? So just a small thesis picture. This is my case study at my university. And the new museum function, conclusion. We have a micro museums, media museum, which is my responsibility. And as a museum people, I keep my territory. Please do not touch my territory. And archival science professor say, please do not touch this area. But making a long discussion, and towards 150 years anniversary of the university, we change a little bit our strategy. Okay, professor, we need a digitization, and this is my responsibility, using my students. Almost historical document are digitalized, but even our university, even innovator like me, we want to keep our territory, as I said. But in order to cooperate with another territory person, we need some kind of information architecture as a basic. The librarian, the professor of library science, she wants to reorganize their own history, library education in Japan. And I want to keep this material, but the professor who specialized in movie or media studies, he wants to digitalize this old media. And the book and the collection like pictures like this, in order to mix together or unify or collaborate, we need an information architecture. So this is the first point for discussion. And then we can distribute the information. So at first we define research design purpose one, purpose two, and the construction of the archives. Museum material and archival materials. Maybe here in this organization you have library, some object, specimen, type, specimen and so on. So using this material or archival paper, line, books and so on, you need information architecture. And then our purpose too is a critical examination of the history of library and information professions. This is for librarian, and this is for me. So even we can keep the territory, but we can discuss in order to get consensus. I think this is most difficult. Very difficult. But conservation or preservation and information utilization, physical, but of course digitally, object environment controls, and information should be recorded in inventory, catalog, information, digital archive. And at the same time, I cannot do, or professor cannot do for digitalization, all the paper, all the material, object. So we use the students, and the students, trial and error, as a practice, they can do, and they recognize the importance of digitalization. So creating new values. So if we consider the museum, traditional museum, we collect, we make a research, and we exhibit, we educate, and conserve. But information level is the same. Data collection and description or registration of this documentation and presentation or interpretation even on the website or a computer screen or something like that, and long-term preservation. So almost the same. Museum, of the museum, by the museum, for the museum. This stream or this strategy is almost the same. So digital heritage, we say, as an information culture. Because, frankly speaking, I don't like information culture as a museum people, but for our dean or our president, we create something new. So we say information culture, but material culture or spiritual culture is important for me. But information culture as well as material culture for future generations. So you can think about this stream or strategy. So this is my activity, educational contribution for Libyan people, and I visited over 10 times, and each year I make a lecture and some kind of documentation or making a scenario, catalog and so on, and discussion like this, and international exchange of the ideas with different perspectives is very important. And this grant comes from Japan Foundation. The Japan Foundation contributed some kind of educational activities. Before, I don't know, before 10 years, JICA cannot accept this kind of educational activities, but up to 25% they can accept for this kind of activities. Not only initial cost, not only for making the road, bridge, or building, but educational activities, training, JICA can accept up to 25% of the budget. And the Japan Foundation, like this, so I listed not only from the budget from Ministry of Education, the Japan Foundation is my sponsor. So during 30 years, what I learned from my experience, for museum people, confidence is very important. Confidence, without confidence, we cannot do trustworthy or human relations. So the coordinator or planner or constructor of the museum, the human relations or confidence, the first priority. And second, object-oriented. Museum people think about object, but for me, the object is number two. It's not number one. And of course, we need information, and management factors such as budget and so on is number three, and time management and accurate information is needed. So for younger generations, three students here. So for your younger professional, I want to insist on the museum development depends on your own career development. So you can use the museum, or you can use the library. A slogan by the UNESCO, it was 1950s, the late 1950s or 1960, museum for all. But as I said, museum concept of museum has already changed. So learning center or hall, or it doesn't matter, but museum, new institution for all, should be open to the public. You can use the your career development for museum development. At the same time, museum can contribute to the younger generations. So conclusion, are you tired? No? This is my last lecture. So listen to me very seriously. I need water. What time is it now? 2 hours already. I finish. Okay, so to sum up, traditional museum function is this. This is according to the, this comes from Observatory Museology 2005. Sensorialization, this means a collection and conservation. This is the first priority, classic idea. And communication, today, Japanese museum is education, interpretation, publication, event, exhibition. And knowledge, research, object research, research, theme, or museography, public, or it doesn't matter, research. So knowledge, experience should be shared. But this is traditional way of thinking. So what's next? Is there anyone who can answer? Next slide. No? I will answer. So new museum function. This is already 2005, so a little bit older. So we have to create a new idea. But museums should be a social actor. This is very shocked for me, because Japanese, even Minister of Education, museum people think museum is an educational institution. We don't say social actor. We don't say, we never say. But at the same time, cultural actor, and surprisingly, museum should be an economic actor, contributing to the economic activity, economy. In order to do this, regional integration is needed. Integration, integrate. Who can do? Who will be the organizer? Who will be the coordinator? Maybe the coordinator understands the importance or the positioning of new museum positioning. Should be social actor or cultural actor and economic actor. That is my conclusion using the idea of Mario. So you can make a, you have already networking with international partners. You have already 11 countries and the regional alliance which is already established. An academic society, not only museum studies, but also librarian, university, Philippine University, University of Philippines, and private sector, company, and so on. And I hope your AgriMuseum project will be a big success. Thank you very much for